A bona fide student of 9A. Today I am going to deliver my speech about the greatest legend, physicist Sir Isaac Newton, on the occasion of World Science Day. Good morning, friends. As you know that science plays an important role in our day-to-day life. You can sit here comfortably in the hall because science is upright here. Earth is like a magnet, so that we can sit, walk, stand, and even express. Don't you know who discovered the force of gravitation? Sir Isaac Newton, absolutely right. Sir Isaac Newton is perhaps the greatest physicist who has ever lived. He and Albert Einstein are almost equally match contenders for this title. Early life and education of Newton. Isaac Newton was born on January 4, 1643 in the tiny village of Wollstone by Cotswold, Lincolnshire, England. His father, whose name was also Isaac Newton, was a farmer who died before Isaac Jr. was born. Beginning at age 12, Newton attended the King's School, Grantham, where he was taught the classics, but no science or mathematics. When he was 17, his mother stopped his schooling so that he could become a farmer, servant and undergraduate. In June 1661, age 18, Newton began studying for a law degree at Cambridge University's Trinity College, earning money as a personal servant to wealthier students. In 1638, Galileo Galilei had established a new scientific basis for the physics of motion with his masterpiece, Two New Sciences. In 1665, at age 22, he was awarded his BA degree in the year. By now, his mind was ablaze with new ideas. Friends, now we get some more information about Newton's greatest discoveries. Newton revealed his laws of motion and gravitation in his book, The Principia, Universal Gravitation and the Apple. Newton's famous apple, which he saw falling from a tree in the garden of his family home in Wollstone by Cotswold, is not a myth. He told people that seeing the apple fall made him wonder why it fell in a straight line towards the center of our planet rather than moving upward or sideways. The force is felt throughout the universe, so Newton called it universal gravitation. Newton discovered the equation that allows us to calculate the force of gravity between two objects. In 1696, Isaac Newton was moving on. Newton was appointed as a warden of the Royal Mint. In 1700, he became master of the Mint, leaving Cambridge for London and more or less ending his scientific discovery book. In 1703, he was elected president of the Royal Society. In 1705, he was knighted, becoming Sir Isaac Newton. The end of Isaac Newton's life is Isaac Newton died on March 31, 1727 at the age of 84. He had never married and had no children. He was buried in Westminster Abbey, London. Thank you, friends, and happy Science Day.